bigger brains enabled them to process complex 3D world in the trees. They stood more erect. From these prosimians evolved a new social animal. Their snouts were more narrow. They could see in color. They were more intelligent. Egyptopithecus marked a divergence of old world monkeys and apes. The common ancestor of the gibbon and human speciated. Common ancestor of orangutan and human speciated. The common ancestor of the gorilla and human speciated. The common ancestor of the chimpanzee and human speciated. It evolved larynx, a precursor to speech. For millions of years, these apes thrived in Africa's Great Rift Valley. But then drought hit. And new walking descended from the trees in search of food. Walking on two legs had many advantages. Improved scope of vision over tall grass. They could travel longer distances. Their hands were freed up to perform other tasks. The drought continued to get worse, and they were forced into a new diet. Meat. Homo habilis was the first animal to construct tools. A diet including bone marrow fueled further brain growth. A more erect posture caused the voice box to descend in the throat. body hair began to shred, allowing sweat glands in the skin to evolve. This enabled them to remain in the sun for longer periods. As sweating replaced panting, the mouth was freed up, allowing for primitive voices to develop. At some point, Homo erectus resisted an instinctual fear of fire, and fire was first tamed. Campfires brought, for the first time, a period of leisure, a time to contemplate themselves and their world. This forward-thinking marked the arrival of a new people, Homo sapiens. They were no longer scavengers, but hunters. A major drought hit, and they migrated towards the sea. A diet of shellfish spurred further brain development. Language developed, as well as art and jewelry. But the sea became too salty, and one group decided to flee Africa across the Red Sea, up the Arabian Peninsula. A lighter complexion enabled their bodies to produce sufficient vitamin D.
Right hand. Right. And the distance from your middle to the tip of your finger represents all the time since life began. That's 4,000 million years. Can anybody guess roughly where, say, the dinosaurs were on this scale?
Yes.
On the wrist?
Yeah, that's not bad. It's surprisingly recent. And all of historical time, that's Jesus and King David and the pyramids and ancient Babylon, the ancient Egyptians, all that time, everything you've ever learned about in history, where do you think that would come?
This far away from your tip of your finger,
no,
or something like that.
It's much further than that. Why do you think I handed out those nail files? You get your nail file and get your middle finger and just do one stroke of the nail file and look at the dust that falls from your nail. And you might see a few grains of dust that fall from the tip of your nail. And the whole of human history has fallen in the dust from one stroke of the nail file. Has fallen in the dust from one stroke of the nail file.
This is a present human being. These are us, people. Complex beings. To remember two simple facts about us. In order to survive, we need food. Food is any substance or materials eaten or drunk to provide nutritional support for the body or for pleasure. It usually consists of plant or animal origin that contains essential nutrients, such as carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, or minerals, and is ingested and assimilated by an organism to produce energy, stimulate growth, and maintain life. This, and oxygen. The rest is depending on the environment. comfort, education, evolution. So, keep in mind this, we need food and oxygen in order to survive. Remember who we are.